Hello guys, welcome to Learning with Prep Class. I am your tutor, Adini. In this video, I'll be solving questions 32 to 35 from the Ugo-Sigo Qualitative Paper B Test 4 questions. After this video, you will have gained understanding on how to carefully select the correct answer when solving questions in quantitative. It's usually fun having you guys around, and I know this video will be a worthwhile session. Do not forget to like and subscribe on our YouTube channel. You can go the extra mile of leaving a comment so we can communicate for effective learning. Without further ado, let's zoom in. Now, this is section I, and it has to do with questions 32 to 35. And with the understanding we gain from these samples, it will guide us in solving questions 32 to 35. Now, if you can see in this bracket, we have number arranged on both sides. Now, this basically means since this is 1 and there's no number beside it, it means it's 1 plus, then 4 times 2 will be in brackets plus 5 times 4 will be in brackets. Since then this is the number on the right hand side and there's no number next to it on the left hand side, so it will be minus 1. You see, it's 1 plus 4 times 2 plus 5 times 4, then minus 1. So then we solve it. 1 is 1, then 4 times 2 is 8, plus 5 times 4 is 20, then minus 1. So it will be 1 plus 8, that's 9, plus 20, 29, minus 1, equal to 28. Alright, let's look at the next one. Now you can see we have 1, 2, there are no numbers beside it on the right hand side, so it will be 1 plus 2 plus 6 times 8 minus 5 minus 2. 1 plus 2 plus bracket 6 times 8 minus 5 minus 2. So it will be 1 plus 2, 6 times 8 is 48 minus 5 minus 2. 1 plus 2 is 3 plus 48, that is 51. 51 minus 5 will give you 46. 46 minus 2 will give you 44. So that's how we got our answer. And for the third one, we have numbers side by side. So it will just be 2 times 1 in bracket plus 3 times 5 in bracket plus 6 times 3. So 2 times 1 is 2 plus 3 times 5 is 15 plus 6 times 3 is 18. And if you add them all up, 2 plus 15 is 17 plus 18 will give you equal to 35. So this is how we'll be solving questions 32 to 35. Let's check them out. So for question 32, we have these numbers arranged both left hand side and right hand side. So let's see how to get it done. So for this, there are numbers side by side. There is no missing part. So it will be 10 times 4 in brackets plus 6 times 0 in brackets plus 2 times 3 in brackets. So 10 times 4 is 40, 6 times 0 is 0, 2 times 3 is 6. So 40 plus 0 is 40, plus 6 is equal to 46. So 46 is our correct answer to question 32. So question 32, 46 is our correct answer. Let's look at the next question. Question 33. We have these numbers, so let's see how to get it done. So since there is no number beside 4, it will be 4 plus then 3 times 2, as written here in brackets, plus 6 times 1, in brackets, minus 5. So 4, 3 times 2 will give us 6, 6 times 1 is 6, then minus 5. So 4 plus 6 is 10, 10 plus 6 is 16, so it will be 16 minus 5. And 16 minus 5 is equal to 11. Let's check it out. Question 33, option A, 11 is our correct answer. Let's look at the next question. Question 34. Alright, we've been asked to find this missing number, so they give us the answer. So let's see how to get this done. So we would assume the missing number to be x, then we integrate it into the equation. We add it into the equation. So the missing number here is x. So it will be normally 6 plus 4 plus 8 times 3 in brackets minus 10 minus the missing number, which is x, equal to 20. So this is how we'll do it. So next, would 8 times 3 is 24. So it will now be 10 plus 24 minus 10 minus x equal to 20. Now, minus 10 plus 10 will cancel out because minus 10 plus 10 is 0. So it will be 24 minus x equal to 20. Now, we need to collect like terms. 24 and 20 are real numbers, but x is a variable. So x will go out. When minus x crosses equality sign, it becomes plus x. Then when plus 20 comes in here, it becomes minus 20 because we are collecting terms that look alike. So x is not looking like 24, so it has to go out. And since it is minus, it becomes positive. 20 is a real number like 24. So it comes in to meet 24 and it becomes minus 24 because it was plus 24 here. So it will be 24 minus 24 and that will give us 4. So it can be written as x equal to 4. So our correct answer here would be 4. Let's check it out. Question 34, option A, 4 is our correct answer. Let's look at the next question. Question 35. It's looking like question 34. So they've given us the total answer. So we need to substitute this missing number as x. Then we solve it. Let's check out how to get it done. So let this missing number be x. So it will now be x plus 3 times 2 in brackets plus 2 times 1 in brackets minus 5 equal to 16. So x plus 3 times 2 is 6. 2 times 1 is 2, then minus 5. So if we add all these numbers together and subtract the ones where necessary, 2 plus 6 is 8. 8 minus 5 is 3. So we need to collect like terms. 3 cannot be added to x. It's not like x. X is a variable. 3 is a real number. So we'll take 3 out to become minus 3 because it is plus 3. Once it crosses this equal sign to the next place, to this next side, it becomes minus 3. So it will be x equal to 16 minus 3. And that will give us equal to 13. So x is equal to 13. So let's check out the correct answer. So question 35, option D, 13 is our correct answer. Alright, this is how far we can go in this video. I hope we had fun. Our answers came out quite easy when we implemented the knowledge from the samples. I'm using this timeout to ask us to join our WhatsApp group using this link below, so we can get updates on more videos to come and we can ask questions and comment on the previous videos we've seen. It was fun having you guys around. Till I come your way again. Bye.